everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Kelsey-Jo Holmes, and in today's video I would like to actually talk about my experience at my old school, which is actually a corner for my college that I am currently in. And college is like a special needs college, but in the school when it's actually a corner for my college, there is a lot of students who actually enter to the school and learn about something new that they never knew, and in extra. So I just wanted to demonstrate to you all about this chain that I have made since I was young. In my old primary school, I met this chain, and it's like a necklace with beads in it. So like, I did actually made it in my primary school. So and we have to sign any words that you know in assembly. So I'd just like to actually talk about you guys about my experience at my old school and what I actually inspire as an autistic woman and people. And I do actually come a long way, a long journey, and I do get really better at communication, but not fully, because I'm still struggling, because I haven't got me confidence to actually talk in front of the people I know. But I don't really trust people, though, I don't know. So this story is about like me living with autism spectrum disorder and what's my autism processes, and what's the purpose of being autistic. And I have actually been diagnosed with autism for a long time, and so I just wanted to read about my experience with autism, because like I said in my previous video, remember this app thing called Inkit, download that please. It will be appreciated if you do, because you do a lot of writing and anything in particular. So 19 years of being autistic. So basically it's like a non-function written news article. Like non-function is like anything that is true. For instance, if you watch the news about Mason Greenwood, that is actually true, because he got being arrested for an assault and a rape. He's only 20 though, that is really bad. His girlfriend's got being hit as well, and he's threatening people. So I'm done about it though. So I'm gonna read this about my life with autism. So what life is like for me to live with autism spectrum disorder. So in my opinion and my point of view, you are different from other people in your primary school in the small world that you are currently living in. You have to have a support worker to help you with your work, help you with anything and the amount of help you need. You used to get hugs from teachers when you were upset, when you needed one so bad. You had to have a speech and language therapist, a therapy, because you cannot communicate fully or use accurate language. Like everybody else has like an expressional way. You wish yourself that you could be like a normal people, like everybody else was in your school. Unfortunately, you are a vulnerable person because if the tutor needs one to, sorry about that, one a teaching assistant to be vigilant on you. After all, you are allowing yourself to do whatever you want. You do not understand the concept of the dangers of safety. You will never get qualifications in life. You will go to an education aid school that will be accessible for your needs because you have a severe learning disability that triggers your social communication and language skills. You cannot control your sadness and anger inside you because this counts as daily emotional meltdowns that you cannot communicate to somebody that you trust, and you can't help yourself when you're having a meltdown. You feel depressed because you have no friends, even if you have no one to talk to, but you made up your imaginary friends to make you feel better and be capable of socializing when things do not exist. The biggest problem you might have in autism that is the most common in autism is separation anxiety. Even though you don't have it, the mind can create emotions inside you that makes it difficult to control your panic attacks or emotion. You don't know how to calm yourself down when you are panic stricken, overwhelmed and upset. You cannot communicate because of your panic attacks. The nerves were much deeper than they will be ever be going to explode. The heart beats faster than you cannot breathe because you suffer from panic attacks because of an anxiety disorder in mental health and autism. Social interaction and communication are your biggest thing to handle when you are autistic. You want it to be alone, so you don't make friends because of your diagnosis of autism. You cannot communicate verbally with other people when you're upset. You talk to yourself most of the time that you have so many imaginary friends or family in your mind that you have asked whom I am talking to, it has turned worse or deteriorating, which word you actually prefer. Wait a minute. I'm going to get a drink because my throat is a bit dodgy. If anyone asks for a flavour of cola, it's actually vanilla, zero, Coke Zero. So, when am I? It has turned worse when you get older. Every year, the amount of anxiety or emotional meltdowns when you are on a autism spectrum has been the worst scenario that you have to deal with on a day-to-day basis. It is pretty embarrassing to see yourself cry. Talk to yourself, be sensitive to noise. Don't let the crowds of people are doing stimming behaviours like such as walking back and forth in public. People in real life can stare or pinpoint at you very easily. It makes you feel very uncomfortable. So this is why you need to be supervised by an adult provision. All people with autism one is comfort from other people in different places, schools, colleges, work placements, and anything that conveys to a world to make you feel better. However, people can be really judgmental, that they moan at you for crying over nothing, that you cannot help yourself because you have to let your emotions and sadness go. Just let the tears drift away from your face. You don't need to wipe your tears off your face because you feel sad all the time. Your autistic brain tells you to cry. Your brain tells you when the mood changes. Your autistic brain makes you unable to have self-confidence, self-control and self-esteem because you want it to be more intelligent than everybody, so you want things to be perfect. You wanted to the originals to be the same as they are. The common problem when you're autistic is the ephemeral relationships with other people because it can be daunting to make friends. Some people need a little bit of company that they don't like to be alone. So it considers something similar to what I usually do. On the other hand, some people don't appeal to you to be friends with them. They are more likely to be an enemy to you because of the disability that you will live with for years. You are more likely to be discriminated against when you're in school, colleges and work. It hurts every day when you lose someone you love and you have been raised by a family member, whenever they are single or not. It's hard to stop thinking about the family you missed. You miss the fun days with your family and your own perfect life. Your behaviour starts to deteriorate when one of your family members has gone to heaven forever and realised you will not see them again. You always feel miserable for the rest of your life. You don't celebrate anything when you get older. You feel like autism has been defeating you. Within the anxiety attacks that occurred when you have an interview, exam or introduction day, it's like that on your first day. The violence inside you has intensified when your autistic brain tells you to do something atrocious that is not unacceptable. You will not always be restrained because of your physical aggression towards other people, but it gets you arrested by the police for aggravated battery or assault on other people you love because you are apoplectic with rage over nothing. You have a target for who you are going for, such as your mum. She is the easier target for you to hit when you are infuriated. You know it is not okay to be hitting someone you love. The activities that you don't like the most, you have to do it urgently. So you have to follow the rules that teachers have set out. The teachers force you to do anything that you don't want. You refuse to follow the simple instructions. If you don't like it, the teacher will ask you to remove yourself from a PE activities. You always be referred to a different class or quiet area if you don't like the crowds of people. You cry over a minor behaviour because you react to a behaviour that differs from the other people. It's like you have been treated differently compared to everybody who is non-autistic in school or at home. Most autistic people are more likely to be excluded from school because of their behaviour. The teacher put them into the behavioural report, which is more likely to be put into the behavioural provision, such as isolation. You cried over the small things that you don't understand what the behaviour is like for a teacher to handle a situation like this. You have been spoken to like that by teenage people or teachers because what you did wrong. 1 minute. Because you did wrong can make you cry quite easily. You have to reflect on the actions that you have caused. Sometimes it can Sometimes it can't make you cry when people use their tone of voice or try to abruptly tell you about things that cause you to be upset and have meltdowns if necessary. When the teachers ask you to stop doing something that you shouldn't do, it will make you speak to the teacher like that because you started having a go at someone when they didn't do anything wrong to you. So next one, it's quite a long story to be honest, but so when my nursery teacher said to my mum, there is something wrong with her because I cannot develop My communication at an expected rate, like everybody else has when they are toddlers. However, my mum can be very opinionated about things when the teacher demands an explanation of what is wrong with me. I don't know what is around me because I cannot speak or defend my mum from teachers at this school. I struggle to express how I felt, and I used to be very, very aggressive to my mum to get my frustration out of the way. I screamed for hours and hours that there is nothing my mum would do to stop me from screaming my lungs out. I am the fussy eater because I will only eat sausage rolls without a pastry. I still do it now. Wotsits, egg mayonnaise sandwich and chips. However, I knew I was a different person compared to all people who hadn't mentally disabled. My teaching assistant took my mum and me to a pediatrician centre to see what was wrong with me. My doctor says to my mum I was diagnosed with autism spectrum disorder that affects my social communication and language difficulties. It says to my mum that I will never achieve my GCSEs such as English, Maths and Science, but he was wrong. I have often to have one-to-one support from any teaching assistant from age 4 until 9 years old because of my diagnosis of autism. When I got older, my behaviour has become progressively worse than expected. I use visual aids for autism with printable pictures to help me know where my lessons are without getting stressed. The teacher has arranged the behavioural chart to help me to keep track of my work or learning, etc. Now I have got support from teachers. I could communicate to my peers and teachers about my basic needs and wants. It feels great when I can speak to everyone I know. Thanks to my little sister Lillamay, who is 14, because she has changed my life completely. However, I struggle with verbal communication, but that I can barely speak to everyone I know. I was overstimulated by the sensory overload that I prefer to be on my own company, developing some imaginary friends, or move away from a situation where it's not crowded for me. The stars that Mrs. Dubs has organised for the class has helped me overcome my sensory overload. My haircut looks ridiculous. In year 4, I made a presentation about myself and what my likes and dislikes are. Claire Renison was my support worker when I was in year 4. She helped me to develop my maths and English skills. Mrs. Renison took lots of pictures of me everywhere I go when it comes to doing specific activities. I got my photo taken with my mum and my brother Charlie. She helped me to get through year 5. I would be so grateful for the help she has done for me. A lot of people in my class seems to be like me. They accept me the way I am. They are very friendly, affectionate and caring. When moving to year 5, Beth was my speech and language therapist. She helped me to overcome my communication and language skills by using small steps at the time. In class, I was supported by Miss Buckley, along with Nicola, Sam and Lamin. I work with small groups of people that will be better for me to try hard as much as I can. My improvement in maths has been a great experience for me to remember my timetables and no time. I practice my multiplications, however, in English it was a different side of the story. I struggle with comprehending language that sometimes my sentences wouldn't make sense. I wasn't making sure that I was reading through my sentences carefully. I started to experience the roller coasters of emotions in me. I was frustrated, confused, and upset about being told off by a teacher, knowing I don't understand something such as developing money skills. In year six, I started to work independently with anything, but it wasn't turn out good. I developed invalid behaviours that led me to copy other people's compulsive behaviours, such as being silly in class. It will start irritate them. I was rude, disruptive. These memories when I am in year six was that I went to Funky and Benny's at the Crown Point with a mixture of year fives and six peoples. I made my pizza. I had chose my toppings to go with the pizza I made at the Funky and Benny's. It was very nice indeed. In July 2013, I went to Funky and Benny's for our lunch. I have chicken strippers and chips for my main and banana custard for my dessert. After, when I ate my lunch at Funky and Benny's, I went to the cinema with year six peoples to watch Monster University. It was an animation movie. When transitioning to high school, I looked around at Redillion School. It was much bigger than it was. They don't have a plan for me to actually look at my timetable and what I have got in September. I was hatred of this high school because this high school was located in Lofthouse, Wakefield. My office teacher took my mum and me to look around Please thought high school, and I did like it, even though it was far. Luckily, I have a specialist transport to travel to school. So that was it then. Sorry for the long video. I'm sorry about the anything that has happened because I got a dodgy throat. So, but anyways, just like my video and subscribe. So I will see you in my next video. Bye. See ya!